Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel and thank you so much for stopping by. If you are new here, then hi, I am Nita. I upload makeup, skincare and beauty related videos almost every alternative day. So please subscribe to my channel and please help my channel to grow even more. So today I'm going to share with you my nighttime skincare routine. Now, nighttime skincare routine is such a thing that I do not dare to skip. I follow this regime every single night and I thought of sharing it with you. So yeah, without further blabbering, let's jump into the video. Now, the first and the most important step is removing your makeup. For that, first I'm using this Physicians Formula 3-in-1 cleansing balm. This stuff is really good for removing your stubborn eye makeup and stubborn liquid lipsticks, and I generally use it for that purpose only. Then taking whatever is left on my hand, I'm just rubbing it all over on my face and neck. And whatever step you are doing for your face, do not forget to apply or repeat the same thing on your neck as well. Now, with a damp cotton pad, I'm just removing the balm. You can always go ahead and wash your face, but I prefer to remove it using a cotton pad. Look how much makeup it has already removed. This stuff is really good, you guys, and this is my current favorite. Now, after removing all the excess balm, I again go ahead and use my simple micellar water, and again I take it on a cotton pad and I just rub it all over on my face and neck, just to ensure that there is no residue of makeup left on my face. Whenever I do a heavy eye makeup, I use the matcha or the Physicians Formula balm, but in general I use this micellar water for removing my makeup. Now, the next and the most important step in my skincare regime is massaging my face. For that, I'm using grapeseed oil. I have been doing this for the past 2 years now and I have seen tremendous result. It helps to get rid of any premature wrinkles, it promotes blood circulation, and it will give you healthy and glowing skin. I fast forwarded these steps because these are the steps that I shared with you in my home facial cleanup video. If you haven't watched that video, then click on the link over there to reach that video. Basically, I'm just doing the same steps. In that video, I told you to repeat each step for 9 times, but on a day-to-day basis, repeat each step for 6 times, and trust me guys, it takes only like 5 to 6 minutes to get done and the results are amazing. But remember, massaging your face can give you great benefits only when you do it in a right way. If you do it in a wrong way, then you will end up having sagging skin, premature wrinkles and tremendous skin issues. I will soon be doing a separate video on this topic only, so please stay tuned. And also, if I'm doing a home facial, then I use a face massage cream. Other than that, I use grapeseed oil, because grapeseed oil has so many great skin benefits. Also, it does not clog pores, it's lightweight, and it does not cause any breakouts. You can use olive oil, almond oil or aloe vera gel as well, but I won't recommend using coconut oil, because coconut oil does clog pores and it may cause breakout as well, so I won't suggest you to use coconut oil on a day-to-day basis. Next, I'm going to go ahead and remove excess oil from my face with a damp cotton pad again. Next, I'm using this Cetaphil Gentle Skin Cleanser. You guys probably know that this is my holy grail product, and I'm just massaging it gently all over on my face and neck. Now, there is another tip. Whenever you are using a facial cleanser or a face wash, massage it at least for 1 minute, because the product needs some time to work on your skin. And if you just like rub it on your face for 10 to 20 seconds and then wash it off, then you won't have much benefit, you know. So always take your time and massage it at least for 1 minute. And I had to wash my face for about 2 times because I applied oil. I'm going to go ahead and wash my face using lukewarm water. Always wash your face using lukewarm water. Never use too cold water or too hot water for your face. I'm taking an ice cube and I just wrapped it in a paper towel. You can use a tissue paper or a handkerchief or any cotton cloth, and I'm just tapping it all over on my face and neck. Now this step is again important for me. It helps to close all those open pores and it also promotes blood circulation. And do not rub an ice cube all its own. Always wrap it in like tissue papers or cotton cloths. Next, I'm taking this Dickinson's Witch Hazel Toner. This is again my holy grail product, and I'm pouring some in a cotton pad and I'm going to rub it all over on my face. Now whenever I apply makeup, I use a toner in this way, like taking on a cotton pad or cotton ball and then rub it all over on my face. But if I'm not wearing any makeup, then I prefer to use a spray bottle and I just spritz some all over on my face and neck, and then I just dab it, you know, so that the product penetrates deep inside my skin. Now I'm taking this vitamin C serum from Pure Majestic and taking a few drops on my palm. First I just warm it up, and then again I just dab it on my face and neck. Do not forget your neck, okay? And always dab it, do not just swipe it, because if you dab this product, it will go deep inside your skin, and this is the best way for applying a serum. No matter what serum you are using, always just dab it the way I'm doing right here. Now I will let it sink in for about 2 minutes before applying any night cream or anything. Now for my night cream, I'm using this L'Oreal Revitalift night cream, and I'm just applying it all over on my face and neck. And if I feel like applying it on somewhere else, then I do so. Like on this area, I feel like they're dry, so I applied some more cream. Now for my eye cream, I'm using this L'Oreal Eye Defense eye cream and taking some of the product on my ring finger. I'm just applying it underneath my eyes and around my eyes, and I'm using a very gentle pressure here, and always use your ring finger while applying your eye cream. I'm also applying on my smile lines as well. Now last but not the least, applying a lip balm. It's again a must. So that's it for this video, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and this video is helpful for you. If you like this video, then please hit the like button and please subscribe to my channel. And if you're not following me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter, please do follow me there. So see you soon in my next video. Till then, bye and take care.